Welcome to the ACG New York Annual Consumer and Retail Conference.
One of the things we have seen, though, is just in general, a lot of these businesses took a much shallower divot than we expected.
A lot of these middle market companies don't have very deep balance sheets and didn't have a great treasury function.
So pleased to be here today with David Baram, who is a superstar in the world of consumer and media.
I think the consumer knows quite well, or has at least an understanding of when someone's being paid for in some form or other to be associated with a brand versus when it's really organic to their lifestyle.
Impulse buying from the couch has never been more prevalent now.
The surplus of liquidity that was pumped into the system certainly helped drive the consumer. I think, too, the lending environment was a lot stronger than most of us would have expected again back in the early days of COVID.
In terms of the things going to have a difficult time coming back, it's going to be retailers who are mall-based.
My experience tells me that even prior to COVID, the luxury market was really a just-in-time type of a market because styles can stale so quickly.
As we put a flagship brand store into a marketplace, it raises all tides for the wholesale business and just the brand recognition.
At the same time, we're seeing record-setting demand. The ability to produce has been inhibited by quarantine processes and people out with COVID and things like this.
I think the concern at the moment really is this next period, because I think there are a large number of retailers that have managed to hold on to this point. You know, they probably haven't been paying the rent up to this point, and at some point that comes back.